just the beginning for us. Amen. Hallelujah. I think, you know, Pastor Christina is right. You know, she remind us this morning, it's just a new beginning. And as I see this, what is that, letter 2. You know, it's just like a sprout. Did you see this, letter 2? It's just like a sprout. You know, it's not something that, you know, is ready to be cut. But it's just like a sprout to me. You know, it's just like a new beginning. It's something that blooming. So I believe that God will use this church even more. Amen. Young, you know, young generation, come on. Hallelujah. It's just the beginning. It's just the beginning. I believe that. And this morning, I don't want to take any longer because I believe two of my beloved brother, you know, I know them more than 30 years. That is the church that believe in covenant. Amen. You know, we still walk together. We still on fire, if I can say it. Still on fire to serve him. You know, I would like to thank you to Pastor Paulus and Sister June. Would you stand, please? They are my pastor. They are my pastor, really. They are my pastor before even I know my calling. They are the one that mold me. They are the one that, you know, teach me how to serve. If you see how the way I serve in this church, it's because of them. Just because of them. Because I do not know how to serve before. They are the one that teach me how to serve. So it's an honor to have my pastor to be here this morning. And also I would like to introduce Pastor Chris Chen. Will you stand, Pastor Chris? Yeah, I know Pastor Chris and his wife more than 30 years also. When I was in school, you know, every time I went to the, what is that, admission office, because he worked at the admission office. Yeah, before I do not know exactly, Pastor Chris, he's not a pastor that time, but he's really on fire. He's really on fire. And even all my friends afraid of him. You know why? Because he always baptized in the Spirit. And the word, you know, he has a gifting. Be careful, church, be careful. When you get close to him, he's just like a prophet. He's just like a prophet. Yeah, he's a prophet, I'm sorry. That's right. Yeah, he's a prophet because, you know, sometimes he just speak to you and, you know, that's the word of God that will change your life. So it's an honor also to be with Pastor Chris. Thank you, Pastor Chris, to be a friend, to be my pastor, to be my mentor, yeah, for more than 30 years as a friend. Yeah, thank you very much. And both of them will give the word of God this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. So I would like to invite, which one first? Okay, Pastor Paulus. Okay, let's give Jeff Houston welcome to Pastor Paulus. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Pastor. Thank you. Thank you, Pastor Somi. I love you. I'm going to speak in Indonesian, if you don't mind, and Pastor Robin will translate for me. Amen. Sekali lagi terima kasih untuk kesempatan yang bisa diberikan kepada saya dan istri saya untuk bisa hadir dalam acara ulang tahun gereja IFJF Houston yang ke-20.
One more time, thank you for giving me opportunity for me and my wife to be here celebrating the anniversary yesterday.
Ya, kita sangat diberkati.
We are so blessed in this event.
Apalagi tadi malam saya melihat.
Especially last night I saw.
All of you from different nation coming together and serve the Lord in one church. I know Pastor saw me for 30 years, but I know the other pastor here, Pastor David, Pastor Simon, Pastor Robin, also for 20 years. And as the history said, that you know, this church started with 12 people, right? That's what last night they say, right? And then now, look at how many people here. You know. And it's not just how many people, you know. I've been ministering for 33 years. But let me tell you from my heart, this is one of the small churches that have many pastors. Give hand to the Lord. And for the pastor in this church, I just want to give you a question. You have to ask yourself. You know, there's so many churches here, right, in Houston, Texas. Why God put you here in this place? I'm sorry, I'm speaking in English now.
It's okay. I'll translate to Indonesian. I'll go both ways.
You know, why God put you here?
Mengapa Tuhan menaruh Anda di sini?
Right? You have to ask because
kita harus bertanya pada diri kita sendiri.
Think about this.
Pikirkan.
Yeah. 20 years ago.
20 tahun yang lalu.
12 people come together.
12 orang datang bersama-sama.
They are not the pastors.
Enggak ada pastor.
Right?
Betul kan?
And they started fellowship. And then now.
Saat ini.
20 years later.
20 tahun kemudian.
We have like how many 100 people here?
Berapa orang di sini? 100 orang.
And how many pastors we have over here?
Berapa pastor yang kita miliki saat ini?
Right?
Betul kah?
So my expectation is 20 years from now.
Berapa tahun dari sekarang?
You know, at least 8,000 congregation, at least.
Paling sedikit 8,000 orang.
Haleluya.
Haleluya.
So this morning I'm not going to preach.
Pagi hari ini saya enggak akan khotbah.
Yeah. I let Pastor Chris preach.
Saya izinkan Pastor Chris untuk berkhotbah.
Yeah. But I just want to finish it what the Lord spoke to me for your church.
Tapi apa yang saya ingin katakan ialah saya ingin selesaikan apa yang Tuhan katakan kepada saya untuk gereja Anda.
Because you know wherever the church that I go that God want me to preach, I only ask God what exactly you want me to say to them.
Kemanapun Tuhan kirim saya untuk khotbah, saya selalu tanya Tuhan, apa yang Engkau ingin saya katakan kepada gereja di tempat saya Engkau kirim.
And the important thing for me is
yang penting buat saya
is not my preaching, it's not my illustration, but the important thing is what God say to the church, to those people.
Yang penting ialah bukannya khotbah saya, bukannya ilustrasi saya, tapi apa yang Tuhan katakan kepada gerejanya.
Like I told you that I've been ministry for 33 years.
Saya sudah melayani selama 33 tahun.
And I saw in my city of Fresno.
Saya lihat di kota saya di Fresno.
I work together, have a networking with other pastors.
Saya ada mitra kerja dengan pastor-pastor yang lain.
And I saw churches.
Saya melihat gereja-gereja.
Have like 300 congregation.
Yang jemaatnya 300 orang.
500 congregation.
500 orang.
1500 congregation.
1500 orang.
20 years ago.
20 tahun yang lalu.
Now.
Saat ini.
About 3-4 of them is gone.
3 atau 4 dari mereka gerejanya sudah hilang, tutup.
So, you know, the important thing is not just, you know, start a church.
Yang penting ialah bukan cuma kita bisa mulai suatu gereja.
But we have to understand why God bring us here.
Tapi kita harus mengerti mengapa Tuhan membawa kita ke tempat ini.
And I believe that the church that Jesus built is Jesus built for us forever.
Dan saya percaya gereja yang Tuhan bangun adalah gereja yang Tuhan bangun untuk selama-lamanya.
Amen. Hallelujah. So last night I was blessed.
Semalam saya diberkati.
And not just blessed to see how the congregation can work together.
Bukan cuma saya bisa melihat bagaimana seluruh jemaat bisa bekerja bersama.
But I saw your pastor.
Tapi saya melihat pastor saudara.
You know, he don't change.
Dia tidak berubah.
Yeah. He's still sweeping the floor.
Dia masih ngepel lantai, menyapu lantai.
Give hand to the Lord.
Puji Tuhan.
Like I told you, I've been ministering. I just come from Indonesia.
Saya datang dari Indonesia.
And you know some of the pastor,
beberapa pastor di Indonesia,
you cannot even shake their hands.
Anda enggak bisa menyalami tangan mereka.
And I don't know how many pastor in Houston you can see they're sweeping the floor.
Dan saya enggak tahu berapa pastor di Houston yang bisa Anda bisa lihat menyapu lantai.
Amen. But one thing, give hand to Pastor Saumi.
Berikan tepuk tangan pada pastor saudara.
Amen. But you know, as a pastor,
sebagai seorang hamba Tuhan,
we have to remember,
kita harus ingat,
We are called to be a servant.
Kita dipanggil untuk melayani.
Servant.
Pelayan.
Doulos.
Pelayan. Doulos.
You know doulos means?
Anda tahu apakah doulos artinya dari doulos?
Slave.
Budak.
Why we are slave?
Mengapa kita menjadi seorang budak?
Why we call ourselves slave?
Mengapa kita dikatakan budak?
Because we've been bought with the blood of Jesus.
Karena kita sudah dibayar oleh darah Yesus.
All of us here.
Semua dari kita di sini.
Was on sale to the world.
Oh, dijual, diobral ke dunia ini.
That's true, right?
Betulkah?
And Jesus come and bought us through His blood.
Yesus datang membayar kita dengan darahnya.
And we all become the servant of God.
Kita semua menjadi pelayan
Tuhan.
Not
just the pastor,
bukan
but
cuma
all
pastor,
of us.
Semua
we
dari kita,
are the servant of God.
Kita adalah pelayan Tuhan.
And we are not just a servant.
Kita bukan cuma
but
pelayan
we are
Tuhan.
A happy servant.
Kita adalah pelayan yang
berbahagia. Because we have a great master.
Kita mempunyai
and his name is Jesus.
Namanya Yesus.
And that's the most important thing.
Itu yang paling utama.
I don't care about myself about pastor. I don't care about myself about how long I've been in ministry. How many churches I've been planting. How many pastor come out from my church. I don't care about that.
Saya tidak peduli berapa orang yang saya layani, berapa orang bertobat karena saya.
The important thing for me that I look up Jesus.
Yang penting saya melihat kepada Yesus.
And I am a servant.
Dan saya adalah pelayan Tuhan.
And let be the glory unto Jesus.
Kemuliaan kepada Tuhan.
I'm sorry. If I continue, it will be too much. So I have to come back because I already make promise to.
Saya sudah janji kepada Pastor Somi.
Somi and Pastor Chris, you know.
Pastor Chris.
I will give. I share the time. I look at.
Saya akan bagi-bagi waktunya.
The time. Anybody the one that hold the sign.
Yang di belakang yang memberikan timer kepada saya.
Last night, honestly, I'm a little bit nervous.
Semalam saya agak gugup.
Because they already remind me, they will show the sign. If
mereka
like,
sudah kasih saya waktu, tinggal berapa menit lagi.
You know, but in this just really good.
Tapi ini baik sekali.
So, you know, I've been preaching in a full gospel businessman fellowship. Are you ever preaching full gospel businessman
ada
fellowship in Indonesia?
Full gospel business fellowship Indonesia?
If you pass like 1 minute and they start...
Kalau Anda kelewatan 1 menit, mereka sudah mulai
yes.
Sekarang. Ingat
and
terus.
If they don't like your preaching, they just speak.
Kalau mereka nggak suka really? Kompas saudara, mereka akan ngomongin saudara.
And sometimes, you know, they only give you like 20 minutes.
Kadang-kadang Anda diberikan 20 menit.
And I preach like 10 minutes, I do altar calling 10 minutes.
Saya kompas 10 menit, saya altar calling 10 menit.
But today I already make a promise.
Tapi hari ini saya sudah berjanji.
And as a pastor, we have to keep our promise.
Sebagai hamba Tuhan, saya akan menepati janji saya.
It's not as a pastor, a children of God need to keep.
Bukan pastor, tapi anak-anak Tuhan.
So let me give five things that God give it to me for IFJF Houston.
Saya berikan apa yang Tuhan berikan pada
first of
saya
all,
untuk gerejamu.
For you, Pastor Somi.
Untuk Pastor Somi.
Yeah. If you keep humble yourself before the Lord.
Kalau Anda merendahkan dirimu di hadapan Tuhan.
God will use you even more.
Tuhan akan memakai engkau secara lebih lagi.
One thing that God wants you to know, you have to know how to handle your success.
Satu hal yang Tuhan inginkan adalah harus tahu bagaimana menghadapi kesuksesan.
If you look at the history of the movement of God in United States of America.
Kalau engkau melihat gerakan Tuhan di Amerika,
you see Pensacola.
Anda lihat Pensacola.
You see Toronto Blessing.
Toronto Blessing.
You see Promise Keeper. You understand Promise what I'm talking about, right?
Anda tahu apa yang saya katakan, ya kan?
What happened? Do you know why it's happened? Why revival dying in United States?
Mengapa kebangkitan rohani terjadi di Amerika?
You know, we have to open our eyes and we have to learn.
Kita harus membuka mata kita dan kita harus belajar.
As if you don't mind, I can say it, you know.
Kalau Anda tidak keberatan,
like a new kids in the block.
Kita seperti anak
we
yang masih
like
baru.
We just like start to grow, you know.
Yang masih
we need
bertumbuh.
To learn. We need to open our eyes to
kita
see
kita
around, right?
Buka mata kita.
And learn from their mistake.
Belajar
and
dari kesalahan
don't do
kita.
Their mistake.
Dan jangan lakukan lagi kesalahan kita.
Amen.
Amin.
So, Pastor Somi.
Pastor Somi.
You know, God want to use you.
Tuhan ingin memakai Anda.
Last night I said.
Semalam saya katakan.
This is only the beginning.
Ini adalah permulaan.
And somebody said, you say that. We're
Anda
not going
katakan,
to stop.
Kita enggak akan
God
berhenti.
Say, when you said that, God say, yeah, I'm not going to stop.
Saya enggak akan berhenti.
Philippians chapter 1 verse 6.
Filipi 1
God is the one who began the good works in you. And I'm certain that he won't stop. Who won't stop? God. Jesus won't stop.
Yesus tidak berhenti.
Before it is complete.
Sebelum itu selesai.
On the day that Christ Jesus return.
Pada hari di mana Yesus kembali.
I believe.
Saya percaya.
Jesus Christ the one that start this church.
Yesus yang memulai gereja ini.
Not Pastor Somi.
Bukan Pastor Somi.
Not anybody.
Bukan orang lain.
But Jesus.
Tapi Yesus.
Give glory to
Berikan kemuliaan kepada Tuhan.
And when Jesus say upon this rock I will build my church.
Ketika Yesus katakan di atas batu ini aku akan dirikan gerejaku.
And as a pastor we recognize that.
Dan sebagai hamba Tuhan kita mengenali itu.
Our church.
Gereja kita
will stand strong.
Akan berdiri teguh.
Amen.
Amin.
But we have to recognize.
Tapi kita harus mengenali itu.
Okay. Number one, this is what the Lord speak to IFGF Houston.
Yang pertama yang
you may be katakan, happy and blessed to see what I have done in this past 20 years.
Engkau diberkati melihat apa yang saya kerjakan.
But this is not all.
Tapi ini bukan segalanya.
Wait until you see what I've been preparing for you for 30, 60, even 100 years.
Tunggu apa yang aku akan lakukan dalam 30, 60, 100 tahun ke depan.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The best still yet to come.
Yang terbaik akan terjadi, saudara.
And for you that just joined with this church.
Buat Anda yang baru bergabung dengan gereja.
You must be excited.
Anda harus bersukacita.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Because the best still yet to come.
Karena yang terbaik akan terjadi.
Look around you and see.
Lihat sekeliling saudara.
This room is not big enough right now.
Ruangan ini enggak terlalu besar.
You need to move very soon.
Ini akan penuh. Kita akan pindah lagi sebentar lagi.
Hallelujah.
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 Second thing.
Yang kedua,
you know in the word of God there is no one word that you cannot find the word of God is the word coincidence.
Satu perkataan yang Anda tidak bisa temukan di firman Tuhan adalah kata kebetulan.
You know what month is this?
Tahu Anda tahu bulan apa saat ini?
June.
Bulan Juni.
It's just June.
Juni.
You know Jewish people.
Okay. Orang Yahudi.
They look at the calendar is different than us.
Kalender mereka berbeda dengan kalender kita.
You know. Yeah. They relate every month with the tribe, the 12 tribe of Israel.
Setiap bulan mereka ada hubungannya dengan suku dari bangsa Israel, 12 suku.
And this month.
Bulan ini, bulan Juni,
they related to the tribe of Zebulun.
Adalah untuk suku Zebulun.
Zebulun. Amen. What is suku Zebulun ya? Apa itu suku Zebulun? Suku Zebulun is talking about
berbicara mengenai
hidden treasure.
Harta yang terpendam.
And how many of you know that we have many hidden treasure here?
Berapa tahu bahwa kita punya harta terpendam di tempat ini? Di tempat ini.
You know, we are too carnal. When every time when we thinking about treasure, it's always like material thing. It's not. It's a spiritual thing too.
Kalau kita berbicara mengenai harta terpendam seperti kelihatannya uang.
And there is many hidden treasure.
Banyak harta terpendam di tempat ini.
In you.
Di dalam saudara. Di dalam saudara. Di dalam saudara.
And never said that I'm too old.
Jangan katakan saya terlalu tua.
One of my church member in Concord, California.
Salah satu jemaat saya di Concord, California.
She's 86 years old.
86 tahun.
And she's ministering in the food ministry.
Dia melayani di bagian makanan.
Every Sunday she still cook, 86 years old.
Setiap minggu dia masak, umurnya 86 tahun.
My prayer worries is 93 years ago,
years
old
saya,
before he passed away.
93 tahun sebelum dia meninggal.
This month of June also,
bulan Juni ini,
is called the month of Pentecost.
Juga dikatakan bulan Pentecosta.
Do you know that today?
Tahukah Anda bahwa hari ini
is the day of the outpouring of the Spirit.
Ada hari di mana Roh Kudus dicurahkan.
Do you know that?
Tahukah Anda?
So my expectation is.
Ekspektasi saya
when Pastor Chris preach.
Waktu Pastor Chris berkhotbah,
the Lord will pour out his Spirit upon us.
Tuhan akan mencurahkan Roh-Nya untuk kita.
And I want to be part of it to receive.
Saya mau mendapat bagian dalam hal ini.
Movement of the Spirit of
gerakan
God.
Dari Roh Allah.
Haleluya.
Haleluya.
Because of time I cannot share more about month of June in a Jewish calendar they call Sivan. Say Sivan.
Katakan Sivan.
Sivan, yeah. Sivan means short.
Artinya
pedang.
Oh, pedang.
And this is the time for the church.
Ini adalah waktu bagi gereja,
especially in United States.
Khususnya di Amerika.
To pick up our sword.
Untuk mengangkat kita punya pedang.
Look around you.
Lihat sekeliling saudara.
Look around our nation right now.
Lihat di negara United kita.
Christian need to wake up.
Orang-orang Kristen perlu bangkit.
We need to rise up.
Kita perlu bangkit.
And don't look up your church. Don't look your ethnic background.
Jangan lihat latar belakang kita.
But look up your God.
Lihat Allah saudara.
When King David facing Goliath.
Waktu Raja Daud menghadapi Goliath,
he didn't come with his own strength.
Dia tidak datang dengan kekuatannya sendiri.
He said, "You come with all the sword, everything that you have."
Ia katakan, "Kau datang dengan pedang dan segala yang kau miliki."
I only come with one person.
Saya cuma datang dengan satu orang.
And his name is God.
Namanya Allah.
Israel.
El Shaddai.
And every one of you here, you have the God of Israel.
Setiap Anda di sini punya Allah Israel.
And that's mean wherever you go.
Kemanapun Anda pergi,
God will using you.
Anda Allah akan memakai saudara.
As long as you are willing to be crazy for Jesus.
Selama Anda ingin bersemangat buat Yesus.
Some of my friend asking me.
Beberapa teman saya bertanya pada saya.
How you are so sensitive to hear God voice?
Bagaimana bisa peka mendengarkan suara Tuhan?
You know, one time.
Suatu saat.
My air condition was broke.
AC saya rusak.
So I went to Walmart with my wife. I went to Walmart.
Oh, saya ke Walmart dengan istri saya.
And while I'm working,
waktu saya berjalan,
somebody read my t-shirt, you know, they have a word on the back of my t-shirt.
Ada satu orang yang lihat tulisan di belakang baju saya.
God got my back. God got my back.
Oh, Tuhan mempunyai, Tuhan ada di belakang saya.
And I said, "Man, I like your t-shirt."
Oh, saya suka t-shirt Anda.
Are you Christian?
Apakah Anda orang Kristen?
Yeah, I'm a Christian.
My son. Ini anak saya laki-laki.
Joshua. And right the moment.
Pada saat itu juga.
Speak to this person.
Saya berkata kepada orang ini.
No. The Lord spoke to me. Speak to this person.
Oh, Tuhan katakan kepada saya.
He has a problem.
Dia punya masalah.
And I call him. I say.
Saya panggil.
You know, I don't know you, but you are Christian. You are brother, right?
Saya nggak tahu. Talk to you. Anda saudara saya kan?
So I ask him to stand aside.
Saya kata ajak dia untuk ke pinggir.
Don't worry.
Jangan khawatir.
I'm a pastor.
Saya seorang hamba Tuhan.
But this is the word of God for you.
Tapi ini firman Tuhan untuk Anda.
And when he hear that.
Waktu dia
my mereka, wife is a witness.
He's istri saya saksikan.
Around. He hold and he say. He call his cell phone.
Dia keluarkan cell phone-nya.
Wow, pastor, you need to see this. Pastor, you need
pastor,
to see
Anda
this.
Perlu melihat
he's
ini.
So excited.
Dia begitu gembira.
Come down, everybody look. Calm down, what happened? You need to look at. You know, he said, I was working here.
Saya bekerja di sini.
I just off 2 hours ago.
Saya baru selesai off. Kerja dua jam yang lalu.
And then 1 hour ago I was praying.
Satu jam yang lalu saya berdoa.
And I'm crying before God.
Saya menangis di hadapan Tuhan.
About this situation.
Mengenai situasi yang saya alami.
And then the Lord spoke to me.
Tuhan berbicara kepada
Go
saya.
Go back to your place.
Kembali kepada tempat
kerjamu. I will send somebody to speak to you.
Saya akan mengirimkan seorang untuk berbicara kepada Anda.
And I'm the answer of God for you.
Saya akan menjawab Anda.
And this not just happen once, many times. But you know, if you doing that, you know, people look at you like crazy, right?
Kalau ini bukan cuma terjadi sekali dua kali. Kalau Anda lakukan ini, orang akan lihat Anda gila, kan?
But you remember this.
Tapi ingat ini, saudara.
You have Jesus not just for yourself.
Tuhan punya Yesus, tapi bukan untuk saudara
salvation
sendiri.
Salvation is not just for yourself.
Bukan cuma untuk saudara sendiri.
Freely receive.
Terima.
Freely give.
Dan terima dan berikan
sebebas-bebasnya. It's not about you. It's about him.
Anda, about Yesus.
Your
Yesus.
Life in this earth just a temporary, brother and sister.
Hidup Anda di dunia ini hanya sementara.
You don't know that every one of you have expiration date.
Anda tahu setiap orang punya ada kadaluarsa.
You just cannot see it, but you have expiration date. You
kita
know that.
Kita nggak bisa tahu, tapi kita kadaluarsa.
And if you don't use your time wisely,
kalau kita nggak mengambil
you will be regret
kita,
when you face with him.
Kita akan menyesal ketika kita melihat
King,
Yesus.
King of Kings, Lord of Lords. You will be regret, brother.
Kita akan menyesal.
Because whatever you done in this world is nothing.
Karena apa yang lakukan kita lakukan di dunia ini tidak sia.
Except if you doing it for his glory.
Kecuali kita lakukan untuk kemuliaannya.
I think already passed. Can I stop here? I'm sorry. But, okay. I'm sorry. You know, we are preachers. Really hard, you know, but
susah sekali buat hamba Tuhan untuk
selalu itu kami continue.
Saya teruskan.
Okay, number three, you know, is
yang ketiga.
Isaiah 22.
Ayat 22.
I will put the key to David's house around your neck. If he open a door, no one will be able to close. And if he close a door, no one will be able to open. This is the Lord speak to your church, Pastor Somi.
Tuhan berbicara ini kepada gerejamu, Pastor Somi.
This is a new beginning.
Ini adalah permulaan.
You are in the year of Ayin Dalet.
Anda di dalam tahun Ayin Dalet.
You know Ayin Dalet? Many of you know.
Berapa yang tahu?
Yeah. In Jewish calendar, we are in the year of Ayin Dalet.
Di dalam kalender Yahudi, kita di tahun Ayin Dalet.
Yeah. Ayin Dalet speak about eyes that see the door.
Berbicara mengenai mata yang bisa melihat pintu.
Yeah. And this year actually is the year of open doors.
Dan tahun ini adalah tahun di mana pintu yang dibukakan buat kita.
Why, Pastor Somi, why you have to wait 20 years to celebrate?
Mengapa Anda menunggu 20 tahun untuk merayakan ini?
It's not because of you.
Bukan
because
karena
of
Anda.
His timing.
Karena waktunya Tuhan.
Because he want you to start with an open door.
Karena Tuhan akan memakai pintu yang terbuka.
And I just want to encourage you.
Saya ingin berikan kau
encourage all the pastor.
Semua pastor di sini.
All the leaders.
Semua pemimpin di sini.
All the congregation.
Semua jemaat di sini.
Open your heart.
Buka hatimu besar, luas-luas.
There are more brothers and sisters will come.
Akan banyak saudara-saudara yang datang lagi.
And when they come,
ketika mereka datang,
they're still new Christian.
Mereka mungkin
still
Kristen yang baru.
Their garbage with them. It's okay. It's you okay. Used to be like that before.
Kita juga dulu seperti demikian kan?
Amen.
Amin.
This is the year of open door.
Ini adalah tahun di mana pintu dibukakan.
So God will open. Not just Ecuador.
Tuhan akan membuka bukan cuma Ecuador.
Amen.
Amin.
You know, many nations.
Banyak negara yang lain.
You remember back in Fresno?
Anda ingat waktu kita di Fresno?
One of our Bible training.
Salah satu pengajaran kitab kita, Tuhan berbicara.
Indeed shall all nations be blessed.
Seluruh bangsa akan diberkati.
Pastor Chris, you remember that?
Pastor Chris, Anda ingat kan?
At that time,
pada saat itu,
I never thought that how.
Saya nggak pernah pikir gimana caranya.
But today.
Tapi hari ini.
I can see.
Saya bisa melihat
God use those generation now all over the world.
Tuhan memakai generasi-generasi itu di seluruh bangsa.
And I believe.
Saya percaya.
I believe that Houston, IFGF Houston.
Saya percaya IFGF Houston.
God will use you.
Tuhan akan memakai Anda.
For many nation.
Untuk negara, untuk bangsa-bangsa.
For His glory.
Untuk kemuliaannya.
Number four.
Yang keempat.
Pastor Somi, God already prepare a strategic plan.
Tuhan sudah menyiapkan rencana-rencana strategis.
So when you go,
supaya ketika Anda pergi,
God already go before you.
Tuhan sudah pergi di depan Anda.
You remember the story of Gideon?
Anda ingat cerita mengenai Gideon?
Who set the plan?
Siapa yang menetapkan rencananya?
The strategy of war.
Who strategi perang siapa
Gideon
yang
menetapkan? Gideon or God?
Gideon atau Tuhan?
God. It's not Gideon.
Bukan Gideon.
Some churches today, you know, some mission, we try to do with our own strength.
Beberapa gereja ingin bercoba untuk menggunakan kekuatannya sendiri.
And God say,
Tuhan katakan,
you know, God know better than we do.
Tuhan tahu lebih baik daripada kita, saudara.
What we need to do is just to obey Him.
Apa yang kita lakukan ialah untuk taat kepada Tuhan.
What we need to do is just to humble ourselves.
Kita perlu merendahkan diri kita di hadapan Tuhan.
So let God get the glory.
Izinkan berikan kemuliaan kepada Tuhan.
Deuteronomy chapter 1 verse 30.
Ulangan 1 ayat 30.
The Lord your God who goes before you will be fighting for you. And he will do such.
Tuhan akan berperang untuk Anda.
When you leave Fresno.
Ketika Anda meninggalkan Fresno,
Pastor Chris probably remember this.
Pastor Chris juga mungkin ingat.
Long time ago we have one song that we like to sing.
Ada satu lagu yang kita suka nyanyikan.
And every time when he have a challenge, he call me and I always remind him about this song.
Dan ketika dia mengalami tantangan, saya selalu ingatkan dia lagu ini.
He did not bring us out this far to take us back again.
Dia tidak membawa kita sejauh ini untuk membawa.
He brought us out to take us into the promised land.
Dia bawa kita keluar untuk bawa kita ke perjanjian.
He did not bring us out this far to take us back again. He brought us out to take us into the promised land. Though there be giant in the land,
walaupun
we
ada
need
raksasa,
not be afraid.
Kita tidak takut.
He brought us out.
Dia bawa kita
keluar. Into the promised land.
Untuk bawa kita ke tanah
Every
perjanjian.
One of you have
Setiap
a promised
saudara,
land. And never give up in your faith.
Jangan menyerah.
Because the Lord who brought you out from Egypt.
Karena Tuhan yang bawa Anda
keluar
dari
Egypt. Also will bring you into the promised land.
Dia akan bawa Anda ke dalam
no
tanah perjanjian.
Whatever your promised land is, God will bring you there.
Tuhan akan membawa Anda ke tanah perjanjian.
It's not by might, not by power.
Bukan dengan kekuatan.
By the Spirit of God.
Tapi dengan Roh Allah.
God will do it.
Tuhan akan melakukannya.
So if some of you have a family problem,
kalau Anda
ada financial problem,
problem,
whatever problem you have this morning,
masalah kekuatan apapun
claim
juga,
the victory.
Tuhan adalah kemenangan Anda.
Because the spirit of the champion is inside you.
Karena roh yang
That's
juara ada di dalammu.
Jesus Christ.
Roh Yesus Kristus.
Jesus never have a plan for you to fail.
Yesus tidak ada rencana untuk Anda supaya Anda gagal.
Last.
Yang terakhir.
Psalm 133.
Mazmur 133.
Behold how good and how pleasant it is for brother to dwell together in unity. Because God will command his blessing.
Luar biasa kalau kita semua di dalam kesatuan karena Allah akan mencurahkan berkatnya.
And this is start from the family.
Ini mulai dari keluarga.
When husband and wife together with the children.
Ketika suami dan istri bersama dengan anak-anak,
God will bless them.
Tuhan akan memberkati Anda.
And when God bless them,
dan ketika Tuhan memberkati mereka,
they will become a blessing for God's
mereka
church.
Mereka akan menjadi berkat untuk gereja Tuhan.
And when God bless the church,
dan ketika Allah memberkati gereja,
the church will bless the kingdom of God.
Dan gereja akan memberkati kerajaan Tuhan.
And this is the desire of God.
Ini adalah hatinya Tuhan, keinginan Tuhan.
Building the people.
Membangun orang-orang
that build the church.
Yang membangun gereja.
And build the church.
Dan membangun gereja.
That build the kingdom.
Yang membangun kerajaannya.
Until the kingdom of this earth.
Sampai kerajaan di dunia ini.
Become the kingdom of our Lord.
Menjadi kerajaan Allah kita.
Our mission is not complete.
Misi kita belum selesai.
And we are all the army of God.
Dan kita semua adalah tentara-tentara
God
Allah.
God bless you all.
Tuhan berkati. Allah.